with hundreds and hundreds of course requests for our classes. Our classes are packed full. We've got a bunch of great kids, and we appreciate you coming out to watch them.
We need to introduce our student directors. They give blood, sweat, and tears as well. Where are you girls?
The most important news! about it, being quarterback is just about the most important thing that will ever happen to me, even if I live to be 100 years old.
Well, that's not likely. No brother long in good shape. Tonight, the Joneses and the Smiths and the Davises are all coming over for dinner, and I want everything to be perfect.
But mother...
Father will have to discipline you if you keep up that behavior.
All Dad will do is read his paper and smoke his smelly old pipe.
Because that's what fathers are good at, Junior. If you work real hard, you'll be a man like him someday. And you'll get to read about important things and make your own special smells. And it won't be very long. Not long at all. So go change.
Gee willikers, Mother.
Mother said go change before it's too late!
Just turn off. outdoor life and assume the emergency preparedness position. Die, govern, remain calm.
That is not perfect. You see, you don't seem to understand. I have been planning this dinner party for a very long time, and nothing, not even the end of the world, is going to stop it from happening. So whether your little manual says it or not, there will be a dinner party tonight, or you will not let you see the apocalypse with everyone else.
Hello there, son. Just your civil defense work. transport in here to supervise this area during the end of the world.
What do you mean, the end of the world? Mother's meatloaf isn't that bad. Abby's not a casserole.
We civil defense wardens do not put on our helmets unless devastation is almost certain. To prevent the end of the world, I insist that everyone assume the emergency preparedness position. Got it. Cover! Remain calm!
Oh, come on, Freddy! You're pulling my leg!
It says right here in the official announcement, which I, a civil defense warden for Area P9, have been given. The end of the world has been scheduled for 7:36 p.m. this evening. Please remain calm. Do not panic. This is not a test.
I guess that means that the game will be canceled tomorrow.
Of course. They never send out official announcements unless it's serious.
And I won't get to play quarterback.
And I would say the possible end of the world is serious.
And Susan Smith will wear my Letterman sweater. And I won't get to hold her hand in the bonfire and will never kiss. I've been waiting a long time to kiss Susie Smith. No bonfire means no kiss. Look at that, just perfect.
That's kind of like a bonfire.
Perfect! Mother would be so proud of me. Isn't this just the perfect evening?
Oh, I guess so. It's like an apocalypse and Armageddon. Personally, I was hoping for a simple earthquake or alien attack. My first genuine sympathy for this. But hey, we work with what we're given.
Darling, put down that paper. The neighbors have stopped by.
The door says to me. Martha!
I said!
Since the TV says it's the end of the world, I'm sure the neighbors wouldn't mind a barrel of a cup of sugar, so you could make me a cake.
And she
and
said,
I says, a cake right now, with everything about to end.
And I said,
he just says, I really would like a cake, Martha.
Oh, Martha, what she's trying to say is your lights are the only lights on in the neighborhood. What with this whole end of the world business? We gotta be fine.
Oh, Mom, George, don't interrupt me. It's not polite. Anyway, since we saw your lights on, since it's the end of the world.
I told them that leaving the lights on was against regulation.
We thought we could just pop on over and see if you would let us borrow.
Manual.
Oh, yes!
doggy in the washing machine to wash it off with lots of soap. He didn't like the spin cycle, though. I think that's why our doggy walks funny now.
So bad.
And we don't want to run out of everything and have to resort to, say, cannibalism. Or something.
Dude, that's a
what the manual has to say about looking pretty during the end of the world.
You're so nice and handsome in your uniform. It just puts the man in the manual when you read rules and stuff to me.
Thank you.
world didn't end after all. I have to take off the official helmet.
That's too bad.